My name is Cheryse Sankar. I'm a health science policy analyst at the NINDS.
Essentially, we're in charge of organizing pain policy here at NIH, and NIH's role for most of the pain research that goes on in different federal agencies. For example, some things that we do include organizing meetings and symposia, and actually writing up summaries for new pain articles that might come out, you know, advances in pain research so that people can understand exactly what's happening, you know, in this stage of the field. And then also we do some analyses that you see here, like spreadsheets and things like that to determine, you know, what kind of research is going on right now in the field of pain and what needs to be done. How can we advance, you know, some particular areas that need advancement.
I'm originally from California. I got my degrees, my bachelor's science degrees in chemistry and biology from UC Irvine. And then I went on to go to graduate school in Michigan, where I got my PhD in pharmacology. And then from there, I actually came to NIH in Bethesda and worked in a postdoc in a research lab here. And then from there, actually decided that I was kind of done with this, with the lab work, and I wanted to actually expand it so that I could work on policy more. So I did a fellowship, a AAAS Science and Technology Policy Fellowship, which was a nice transition between the two. And I worked for NCI, the Cancer Institute, for a while. And then from there, I actually got this job here, working as a pain policy analyst. I would say my mother was the biggest influence on me. And that was simply just because she pushed me to kind of pursue, you know, school, pursue education. Okay. She was the driving force behind me going all the way through, you know, my bachelor's and then going to get my PhD. So my first interest actually came from a personal story where a family member had an addiction to drugs. And I became so fascinated by this idea that, you know, you could take a pill and, you know, some series of events happens that makes it so that you lose control. When I was an undergrad, I took this class that actually taught how different drugs worked. From there, I decided to kind of pursue, you know, chemistry and keep it going and learn more about it. So I enjoyed working in the lab because I was able to focus a lot on one particular thing, right? So that's one aspect of it, but there's another aspect of science where you want to really try to integrate all of the different science that's going on. And so I wanted to approach it from a broader perspective. You know, research is wonderful, and there's a lot that's being done all around bringing it together and using it to kind of influence policy and to establish, you know, new public health sets. You know, I think that that's a really important aspect. Leaving the bench was difficult in that it was a little bit of an unknown, right? So I didn't know how good an analyst I would be. That was pretty much all I knew how to do was, I did experiments. So that was kind of what I knew how to do. And so it was a little nerve-wracking to move from that and wonder if I would be a good enough, you know, analyst. I think if you start from a broad perspective of science, you might decide that there's something in particular that you want to study and be able to focus on that, but there's also plenty of different scientific careers out there where you can apply a broad, you know, understanding of science, whether that's being a professor and teaching or, you know, influencing policy. The biggest challenge was deciding to move away from home and commit to a long, you know, graduate journey. Being around family and having that support system was a big deal for me. I think that working here makes me feel like being away from home and family and everything is well worth it, because I support the mission of NIH and I think that it's really important what we're doing here, and I see that with all of my other coworkers as well. NIH is really a place where people, you know, look to us to kind of be that source of hope when they don't really have any options otherwise. It's a very rewarding kind of thing to be influencing pain policy and trying to, you know, improve the state of the public health system, essentially. So don't give up would be my biggest advice, especially when you get to certain areas, like if you're in a physics class, for example, in undergrad, and it's really challenging. You know, don't give up. Keep trying to figure out little pieces at a time
you know, and then take the next step and, you know, take the next challenging class. And before you know it, you'll be in graduate school and trying to figure out how you're going to make your experiment work. And, you know, it's the same kind of strategy. Don't give up. You know, when you're in graduate school, you have to just keep going, and eventually you'll get to the stage where, you know, you're rewarded for your efforts. Science seems like it might be overwhelming and difficult, but in fact, if you just take it one step at a time, you can get there.